nice.
Hello.
Morning.
How are you?
Alan Saffron, how are you?
Alan, good to see you.
Thank you very much for coming. This is my wife, Jen.
Jen.
Jen, good to see you.
When Chef Ramsay arrived, it just blew my mind.
Let's sit down and have a chat, shall we, yes?
I mean, we've got Chef Ramsay in here to improve us. Otherwise, what the hell is he here for?
Nice to meet you both.
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you. How long have you been open?
16 months.
So 16 months ago?
Yeah, yeah.
So just opened?
Yes.
Is the business making money?
No. We're losing 5,000 up to 6,000 a month, every month.
Wow, wow, wow. How can it go so wrong?
I think it was a combination of a lot of things that I think we did wrong. I think we changed the menu too many times.
How many times have you changed the menu?
Probably 10.
10 times?
Yes.
That's nearly once a month. What about the chef? I mean, normally a menu changes when the chef changes. How many chefs have you had?
About 10.
10 as well?
Yes.
Front of house been as bad?
Yeah, we've been through about 20 servers.
10 menus, 10 chefs, 20 servers. What's going wrong?
Yelp has killed us. Yelp has trashed us terribly. They're also deleting 5-star reviews.
Oh, come on.
I can prove it. I can show you right on the Yelp.
Is there a plot against you from Yelp to close this business?
No question in my mind.
Oh, Alan, come on. You've been watching too many fucking Bond movies. So, opening restaurants in LA is pretty expensive. Where did the money come from?
Alan had about $250,000 that he inherited from his dad's estate.
Okay, nice.
So he put all that money into it, and then we started running out of money. And in order to open, my husband went to my son.
Mm-hmm.
And now my son, Daniel, is in for another, I think, over $250,000 as well, because he inherited some money, too.
I was managing his money, so I actually took part of that money.
And as the manager of his funds, you then invested in the business.
Yes.
Did your son Daniel know?
Well, of course, he knew eventually.
What do you say eventually?
I told him after the fact.
What?
I kind of forced him into it by taking his money.
Seriously? Is Daniel here? He's in the business.
He does the nighttime shift.
Okay. You work in the
daytime.
Daytime.
Yes.
And you don't work together?
Not really that much. Our heads log together.
Right.
My son has a great deal of resentment towards me, and I don't know why.
What about the food?
I think it's pretty damn good now, yes. I'd say it's 4 to 5 stars.
4 to 5 stars, so you're 1 star out. Okay, I can't wait to taste it. I've got the background, thank you, I appreciate it.
Okay, thank you. Chef Ramsay will love my burgers without a shadow of a doubt.
I'm Marilyn.
Marilyn, nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
First off, what's wrong with the restaurant?
There's lack of management,
right.
And burgers, they're never cooked right. They're always sent back.
Wow.
Yeah. I tell people that I'm sorry probably 15 times a night. There's no consistency whatsoever. And that's wearing on me, like, as a person. I go home and I'm like, oh, I feel so guilty for serving bad food.
Okay, let's start off. I'm in California, so let's go for California burger,
California,
please.
Sure.
Thank you.
And how would you like it cooked?
Medium rare, please.
Medium rare?
Thank you.
Okay.
No, definitely cowboy burger.
Okay.
Gotta see the Australian meat pie.
Yeah.
Obviously, I'll have to go for the award-winning burger.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we're done. Thank you, my darling.
Good. Thank you.
Good to see you.
You too.
Dirty plates, guys. Come on.
Okay. This is a lot of food.
At first, I loved working at Burger Kitchen, but all I'm doing now is fighting with the management.
David, I'll handle this.
Jen, I want you to get out of the way right now. It's a runaway restaurant, and I have no control.
13 said their burgers were too
good. Hey, Lena.
Yes.
Anything you have to say, go through me.
Jen, okay. I'm not going to tell you more than once. Get out of the way.
Chef David does not like me. He doesn't want me in the kitchen.
Oh, my God. That woman, she's a nightmare.
And he tends to gossip and blame me for a lot that's going on.
Out walks the Diabla.
We've made some errors here in staffing.
This is like a three-ring circus.
Chef Ramsay, I noticed you ordered the cowboy. That'll take a little longer.
Don't you worry.
That's a 1-pound burger. Lovely.
Executive chef, David Blaine?
Yes.
What, the magician?
No, he's not the magician.
Right.
He's just coincidentally the same name. He was the head pastry chef at the Peninsula Hotel.
And now he's the executive chef of the burger restaurant.
Yes.
David Copperfield, your dessert chef?
No.
David, he was like
Chef David Blaine, like the magician.
Too bad I can't disappear from here.
When I came in here, I wasn't allowed to do any of my recipes. I had to do exactly what Alan told me to do.
That's the California.
Even if I knew it was wrong, I still had to do it.
This is the California burger.
Wow. Thank you, Dan. Okay, California burger.
I better let you eat.
Yes, please.
I'll leave you to it.
Thank you. Jeez. Well, it's mid-rare, it's raw. Bread's just sweet, sweet and doughy. Bland, tasteless, raw meat. No flavor. Wow, that's nasty.
How are you doing?
Yeah, that's rough. Does anybody season anything? Yeah, and do the kitchen cook the seasoning?
I know they throw a little bit of salt in.
Well, they're obviously blind because they're missing it. I mean, that is ghastly.
What's wrong with this one? What? Stop. What's wrong with that one?
No seasoning. He doesn't like it.
It's one of the best burgers I've ever tasted in my life. So it's very disappointing. Okay, this is a natural.
All right. Natural with white cheddar.
Yes. How was it cooked? What do you ask for?
No, that's good, medium rare.
Oh, we're good on it?
Yeah.
And this one is?
Natural with white natural. Cheddar.
Oh, this is award-winning.
Yeah.
Great. Thank you, man. Mmm. Wow. It's raw. Wow. That's the award-winning burger. Shocking.
Marilyn, sorry, man.
I know I asked for it mid-rare, but that's a first for me. They serve a burger with a tartar in the middle. That's just raw. All
it is raw. It is raw.
I can't believe that my burger was that bad. That is just shocking. I don't know what to think anymore.
If it's natural, it's raw in the middle.
Oh, come on, guys.
What the fuck is that?
I was shocked that it was undercooked because I okayed the burger. But, you know, we were under a lot of stress.
David, this is really bad.
But instead of looking at their own deficiencies, they wanted to put it on me.
I'm about done with this childish shit here, man.
I'm out of here.
Don't leave, yeah.
100%, I am their scapegoat.
I'm about to blow up. People are crazy.
I left out of frustration. But when I came on, I made a deal with my staff to stay. And I keep my word, and that's what I'm doing.
Let's do this.
Okay, we got the big cowboy burger, medium rare.
Okay, we don't have any of those extra big buns.
No, this is the regular.
Oh, this is gonna be interesting.
We got the cowboy done.
I'm terrified to bring out of this burger. I don't even think he could swallow the thing. He tried. Here is the cowboy burger.
Cowboy with a very small hat on top. Look at the bun. Where'd you start? Honestly, look at that. Come on, seriously? $39. You'd expect a decent bun. Greasy, cooked to hell. Damn.
Thanks, man.
That is dreadful. Dreadful.
I'm so sorry.
Thank you. It's not your fault. Wow.
I was shocked, disappointed, embarrassed, hurt.
Beef pie's up, guys.
But one thing I have that's a little different is an Australian meat pie. The Australian meat pie is the number one staple in Australia. I have brought them to America, and Chef Ramsay will absolutely love it.
That's Ramsay, by the way.
He's not gonna like it.
What?
He's not gonna like it.
So this is the...
The Australian meat pie.
Oh.
The beef.
To go down under. What is that thing? What a mess. I mean, that is disgusting. That Australian pie can fuck off back to Australia with pleasure. I I've got raw doughy pastry on top and soggy, gooey stuff on the bottom. One word for this, meow, cat food. Disgusting.
Didn't like nothing at all, nothing.
I mean, we've got
Nino
in here to improve us. Otherwise, what the hell is he here for?